So far we have learnt how to find the value of an algebraic expression depending the value of the variable present in it. Now let us see how we can use the algebraic expressions while writing the formulas and rules in mathematics. So let us write now using algebraic expressions. In formulas and rules. Now let us see how the formulas and rules in mathematics can be written. So actually the formulas and rules in mathematics can be written in concise form or in the general form using the algebraic expressions. Now how to write the formula or rule in mathematics? Let us see now. First, we will write the formulas regarding the perimeter. So, perimeter formulas. So, while writing perimeter formulas for any geometrical figure, now if there is an equilateral triangle, so when the three sides are equal, so the what is the perimeter of an equilateral triangle whose side is A? So, perimeter of equilateral triangle P equals to sum of the three sides. So here we get a plus a, that is 3a. So when the square is there of four sides, so what is the perimeter of square whose side is a units? Now perimeter of square P equals to 4a. Now if there is a regular hexagon whose side is a units, regular hexagon means all the sides are equal, so if the side of the hexagon is a units, then perimeter of regular hexagon P equals to 6a. So these all formulas are written using the algebraic expressions. So when we know the value of the side of the equilateral triangle, then we can find its perimeter. Now let us see how to write the area formulas. If there is a rectangle whose length is L and breadth is B, so length of the rectangle is L and breadth of the rectangle is B, then area of rectangle A equals to L into B. So if there is a triangle whose base is B units and height or the altitude is H units, then area of triangle A equals to half into base into height. Then what is the area of the square whose side is A units? So area of the square is A equal to A square. So here also these are all algebraic expressions. So using these algebraic expressions, we can find the area of rectangle or area of the triangle or area of a square depending on the values of the variables present in it. If we substitute L value, B value, different values, then we will get the areas of different rectangles. So here we are using the algebraic expressions to make the formula of any geometrical figure. Now let us see what are the rules for number patterns. For example, if a natural number is denoted by n, then what is its successor? Its successor means a number which is added by 1 is called its successor. So if a natural number is denoted by n, then its successor is denoted by n plus 1. Now this is a rule for the number patterns. If a natural number is denoted by n, its successor is denoted by n plus 1. For example, if a natural number you take n value 7, then its successor n plus 1 equals to 7 plus 1, that is 8. Now the second rule, if a natural number is denoted by n, then even number is 2n, and the odd number is 2n plus 1. For example, if n value is 2, then even number equals to 2 into 2 plus 1. 2 into 2, that is 4. Then the odd number equals to 2n plus 1, that is 2 into 2 plus 1, that equals to 4 plus 1, so that is 5. So these are the rules for the number patterns. So if any natural number is denoted by n, its successor is n plus 1. If a natural number is denoted by n, then even number is 2n as well as the odd number is 2n plus 1.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.